and pretty much this time too, it's like the last 10, maybe even 5 years. And we had to rehearse at 7:30 in the morning.
Yep.
We bought lots of donuts and coffee and got people involved that way, which was great. And then the next year, we were all prepared to play a concert in April, but that would have been 2020, and so we know what happened in 2020. And so we had a lot of progress towards a performance, but did not have the chance to perform. And then 2021
was... Oh, I remember that, yeah.
Yeah.
The brass came in.
Yeah. We had some guest students, ensemble came in and performed as well at that concert. And we had some crazy disco lights happening. Mm-hmm. And
oh, yeah, there was a... with the rock out piece.
So we had a lot of interesting pieces on that concert. And then the following year we had an opportunity to perform at the College Band Directors National Association Conference. I saw the call put out for ensembles to come play at smaller venues because of, again, we were still in our COVID era. So they were looking for, rather than big college bands to perform, right, our like wind symphony size, they were looking for smaller ensembles. So I thought, well, this would be absolutely perfect for the new music ensemble. And then there was also the caveat of it being possibly at a brewery, which I was like, well, that's perfect for NuMIX. It's awesome. We can perform at, you know, one of the breweries in Columbia, South Carolina. Our music is, as you'll see tonight, pretty hip usually, and we have different atmosphere pieces that kind of fit well. So we took a group of students to Columbia, South Carolina last February, and some of you were there, and performed for the College Band Directors National Association Conference in Columbia. And that was a really great experience. This year has been full of a lot of stuff for both Dr. Binet and I, but we were able to find a couple of really interesting pieces that we wanted to perform with our students and for you tonight. So I think we're all set to go, and so without further ado, we'll let our first group come on stage with 2 by 8 musicians. Here we go.
Thank you. name is Isaac Amaya. I play trumpet here at UNF, and I'm actually the composer for the next piece that we're coming up the play, Fairy Tale Romance. So this piece is kind of an encapsulation of my journey here at UNF. And it's kind of a mix between classical and jazz, which again kind of relates back to the fact that I'm kind of going between both the studios quite frequently. And there are various points in the piece that kind of are supposed to resemble obviously big moments in my time at UNF, such as the first really noticeable one would be COVID, where things kind of go all crazy and intense, like, oh, are we gonna come back to campus? Like, there's this whole virus coming on. But I hope you enjoy just a peek into what my experience has been like at UNF. And before I go back, I just want to say thank you again to Dr. Bodner, Dr. Vinay, and the ensemble for being willing to play this piece for me.
Thank you.
ensemble out in Colorado called the Grand Valley University New Musical Ensemble. And I have to say, I steal a lot of music that they've commissioned. Well, I don't steal it, I buy it. but this is one of the pieces that I heard first performed by them. I'm not sure how many other performances it has had so far, but the Grand Valley University New Music Ensemble, they had commissioned composers to write pieces based on the national parks. So last year we played a piece called Bite the Dust that was based on that, and then this one as well, and we'll also do another piece, the second piece after this will be the Blue Glacier Decoy is also one of those pieces. So you'll hear very much kind of the nature theme throughout this piece as well as the next one too. So we hope you enjoy Firehole Miss.
Thank you.
context for this piece as well, because you're going to hear our first piece with some electronics as well in this one. So Jennifer Jolley wrote, "This year's obituary in the New York Times for the modern dancer and choreographer Trisha Brown only casually mentioned her debt to the landscapes of the Pacific Northwest. It was unusual characterization for an artist who once told her fellow Washingtonian, the choreographer Mercy Cunningham, that the rainforest was my first art class. Indeed, the Pacific Northwest instruction is found in many of Brown's works. Her 1970 piece, Flora of the Forest, employs a steel scaffolding to hold a cloth canopy of ropes, threaded with colorful used cloth, to create a synthetic forest where the dancers wiggle. Her 1979 piece, Glacier, Decoy, is similarly derived from these experiences. In this work, Brown and Robert Rauschenberg created fleeting images via gossamer-clad dancers and an ongoing found image slide projection. The mechanical and physical movements became an elegant analog to the glaciers. The images and dancers move and shift forward and back, side or other side, or anywhere in between, like a lateral melt. The fleeting projections become a visual metaphor, melting and congealing anew." And Jennifer Jolley says, "I have never been to Olympic National Park, so I followed Brown's example and combined my own experiences with what I learned from an artist who followed the Ho River Trail, studied the Ho Rainforest, and revered the Blue Glacier. We should follow her lead and do the same. We must give ourselves a moment to feel this very mobile sense of how the balance is."
The basic premise in Glacial Decoy is that at any moment your weight could go, your weight could shift forward, could shift back, just tiny, tiny right now. Could shift side, could shift other side, or anywhere in between. So just give yourself a moment to feel this very mobile sense of how the balance is.
Thank you.
just tiny, tiny right now. Could shift side. Could shift other side or anywhere in between. So just give yourself a moment to feel this very mobile sense of how the balance is.
Something that's unique about the NuMIX ensemble is not only that we play new music that has been composed fairly recently, also we have a mixed instrumentation, which, I mean, you might see in other ensembles, but as you've noticed, there's a slightly different instrumentation for every piece. So we don't have a standardized group of people. We kind of pick pieces and look at the instrumentation, and it can be a total mix. You can have strings, you can have winds, you can have electric guitar, piano, electronics, and I think that is something that's unique about the things that we do. We find these pieces, and it's a whole eclectic mix of instrumentation that can be different for every single piece, including electronics. The name NuMIX is a mashup of new music plus mixed ensemble, if anybody didn't get that. We thought it was pretty clever when we came up with the name. But these students are often playing in wind symphony and an orchestra, but we also have like brass ensembles and clarinet choir where it's all a single instrumentation. So this is unique because we have a mix of students from the jazz department and from piano and strings and winds and percussion. And we've also done pieces with vocalists in the past. So it's kind of cool because we're including people with skills from all across the department, including electronics, and finding music that kind of does that. And I think with a lot of the new compositions and a lot of the new music that we find, you know, it's kind of, I think sometimes it's like, what are the most random instruments that you hardly ever see play together, and we're going to put them together and learn how to make music. And sometimes it's fun to write music for that too, where you're looking for that specific thing. So kind of anything goes. So that's a unique thing about this mixed ensemble, is it's a unique experience and kind of a mashup of a lot of diverse pieces and sounds. So I think I can tell some jokes here. Thank you so much for coming tonight. We have fun really doing this, and usually it's a spring concert series that we do with the NuMIX ensemble. And yeah, give me jokes.
Keep going.
All right. Did you know that Chuck Norris can divide by zero? And Chuck Norris can slam a revolving door. Think about that. Yeah. See, that's good.
Yeah.
See, Chuck Norris is still funny. But he's still going.
Oh, you're done.
All right. Sweet. Thank you.
Dr. Renee and I kind of scour the internet for pieces to perform with NuMIX. And this piece, again, Grand Valley University, I'm indebted to them for finding really cool music. This one just grabbed me, and I listened to it probably, 20 times one night because I just couldn't get enough of it. So I hope you find it as intriguing as I do and we do on stage. That's the wrong score, so hold on. Thank you. left you thinking. And if you want to see another concert that will leave you thinking as well, next Wednesday, 7:30, an hour later, in the big theater, the Concert Band and Wind Symphony. We hope to see you there. John Mackey will be with us, so it'll be great to have him compose our four pieces that night. So